students, I welcome you all in this practical lecture of pharmacology and toxicology. So in today's lecture, we will proceed for the experiment number 10. So aim of this experiment is to interpret from the graph by observing the effect of acetylcholine on isolated rectus abdominis muscles of frog by using CD of MSVT.
Aim of this experiment is effect of acetylcholine on rectus abdominis muscle of frog.
Objectives of this experiment are to know that rectus abdominis is a skeletal muscle, to locate rectus abdominis on abdominal wall of frog, to observe and understand rectus abdominis is responsible for compression of abdominal organs and to flex the vertebral column in lumbar region. To understand that acetylcholine is responsible for contraction of rectus abdominis.
So requirement for this experiment, animal, frog, physiological salt solution, frog ringer, drug, acetylcholine, 1 mg per ml, instruments or equipments we need, Sherrington's rotating drum, student's organ bath, aeration tube, aerator, frontal writing lever, stand, clamps, plasticine, wax.
Rectus abdominis muscle of frog is a skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle functions to move bones of the skeleton and thereby regulate movements of the body. Skeletal muscle tissues are also known as striated muscle. Skeletal muscle are voluntary type and are controlled by nerve cells of somatic system. Muscle tissues have special properties like excitability, contractility, extensibility, and elasticity.
Okay, so we must see the effect of acetylcholine on the rectus abdominis muscle of frog. Okay, so this rectus abdominis muscle of frog is a skeletal muscle. So skeletal muscle's function is that it causes the move bones of skeletal and thereby regulate the movement of the body. Okay, apply body to movement regulate karachi kaam je ahe te skeletal muscle karta. Manje jase apan chalu shakto kiwa ekada haat uchalu shakto, haat pay halu shakto, which is due to the movement of that skeletal muscles. Okay, so skeletal muscles are the tissues which is also known as striated muscles. Okay, so ithe tumhala ji image diste the skeletal muscles che ahe ki jacha madhe muscle fibers ahet. Okay, and those muscle fibers are formed by the formation of bundle of myofibrils. Okay, and ithe tumhala neuromuscular junction tya muscles la attach zalele ahe ki jithe nerve ending je ahe ti muscles sobat attach zalele ahe tithe neuromuscular junction as the, okay. So skeletal muscles are voluntary type and are controlled by the nerve cells of somatic system. Okay, but skeletal muscles je ahet manje jancha through apan movement karu shakto te kasa ahet voluntary type ahet manje aplya ichche nusar apan movement karu shakto. Okay, so muscle tissues have special properties like excitability, contractility, extensibility, elasticity. Okay, so these are the certain special properties which is possessed by this skeletal muscles tissues. Okay,
a physiological contact between somatic nerve cell and skeletal muscle is called neuromuscular junction. At this synaptic junction, acetylcholine is released from the end plate of somatic nerve cell. Acetylcholine is a natural neurotransmitter at neuromuscular junction, and after its release, it interacts with nicotinic receptors of skeletal muscle. This interaction is responsible for muscle contraction.
Okay, so this is the mode of acetylcholine. Okay, so this acetylcholine is a parasympathomimetic drug. Okay, means this acetylcholine which possesses or exerts a similar effect to that of parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, so it acts on the muscarinic and nicotinic receptors. Okay, so it produces their effect by acting on muscarinic and nicotinic receptors. Okay, so frog rectus abdominis muscle is a skeletal muscles. Okay, and acetylcholine acting on this skeletal muscles by acting on the nicotinic receptors. Okay, मग स्पेसिफिकली त्या स्केलेटल मसल्सवर जे निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर्स आहे त्याच्यामध्ये एनिम टाईप रिसेप्टर जो आहे त्याला बाइंड होऊन ॲसिटॅलकोलिन जो आहे तो रेक्टस ॲब्डोमिनस मसल्सवर त्याची ॲक्शन शो करणार आहे. ओके, अँड दिस ॲसिटॅलकोलिन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन ऑफ दॅट रेक्टस ॲब्डोमिनस मसल बाय ॲक्टिंग ऑन द निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर विच इज प्रेझेंट ऑन दॅट स्केलेटल मसल्स विच इज प्रेझेंट ऑन द रेक्टस ॲब्डोमिनस रिजन. ओके, स्पेसिफिकली एनिम टाईप निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर आहे त्याला बाइंड होऊन ॲसिटॅलकोलिन त्याची ऍक्शन शो करणार आहे. इट कॉजेस द कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन ऑफ दॅट मसल्स. ओके,
ॲसिटॅलकोलिन आफ्टर इंटरॅक्टिंग विथ निकोटिनिक रिसेप्टर इंड्यूसेस चेंज इन मेम्ब्रेन पोटेन्शियल अँड इंड्यूसेस इन्फ्लक्स ऑफ सोडियम आयन्स अँड कॅल्शियम आयन्स इन साइड द सेल. दिस लीड्स टू मसल कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन.
Means what happen here? When acetylcholine binds to the nicotinic NM type of receptor, it causes the opening of that ion channels and influx of sodium and calcium ions inside the cell. Okay, and this positive ions deposition inside the cell that leads to the muscle contraction. Okay, so त्याच्यामुळे rectus abdominis muscles जे आहे त्यांचं contraction होणार आहे. Okay, so we will see the assembly setup for this experiment. First is organ bath.
Assembly setup. The assembly setup for experimentation of frog's rectus abdominis muscle preparation consists of organ bath. The organ bath consists of an outer jacket, which is also known as water bath, made up of steel or glass. Organ bath also consists of thermostatically controlled heating rod, which maintains uniform temperature of water in outer jacket. It also consists of tissue bath, made up of glass with a capacity from 10 to 50 ml with both sides open. Isolated muscle preparation is mounted in upright position in this tissue bath. Aeration tube made up of glass has dual functions. One, it will aerate mounted muscle preparation, and second, it serves as the tissue holder. The other end of tube is connected to aerator. The bottom end of tissue bath is connected to rubber tubing, which serves as outlet. The bottom side of organ bath consists of an outlet for removing water from outer jacket.
Next is that recording liver.
Recording liver. To record the responses of drugs on muscle preparation, one can use either simple liver or frontal writing liver. Frontal writing liver is made up of light aluminium and is designed in such a way that the writing tape rotates freely about its axis. For proper recording of responses, adjustment of magnification of liver is necessary. magnification value is calculated by using following formula. Magnification value is equal to distance between fulcrum and writing point upon distance between fulcrum and the point of attachment to the tissue. For recording the effect on frog's rectus abdominis muscle, 5 to 10 pole magnification is required. For proper recording of responses and for proper relaxation of muscle vibration after drug effect, application of proper tension or load is required. For example, for frog's rectus abdominis muscle vibration, the tension prescribed is 1 to 5 gram. This tension is applied on longer arm of the leg.
Next is that Sherrington's rotating drum and device.
Sherrington's rotating drum. It is also known as kinograph. It consists of circular drum, speed regulating gear, shaft to which drum is connected, and main on or off switch. It has clutch lever, screen lift to alter the position of drum, and electrical striker. Kinograph paper is wrapped on circular drum and is smoked with black smoke of kerosene or benzene.
Okay, so this is the assembly setup for this experimentation. The next part is procedure. So first we will see the isolation technique. Okay, so here it is, we use the rectus abdominis muscles, right? So from frog, how the rectus abdominis muscles are get isolated? So this video is for that purpose, isolation technique of rectus abdominis muscles from the frog.
To study the effect of acetylcholine on frog's rectus abdominis muscle, select healthy frog. Pinch the frog with the help of pinching needle. Now, pin the limbs of the frog to dissecting tray. Remove the abdominal skin to expose rectus abdominis muscle. To isolate rectus abdominis muscle preparation, take side cut on rectus muscle. One can prepare two muscle preparation from a single frog. Now tie a thread to the bottom and top of rectus muscle before removing muscle from the body of the frog. Mount this rectus muscle preparation in upright position in the organ bath containing frog ringer solution under a tension of 1 to 5 gram. Now relax the tissue or muscle for about 45 minutes, during which wash this preparation with fresh quantity of ringer for at least 3 times. Now this preparation is ready for experimentation.
Okay, now there will be a adding of drug is there.
We have already learned the isolation technique of frog's rectus abdominis muscle and the setup of assembly. Now stabilize the mounted muscle preparation for 45 minutes in frog wringle solution. During this period, wash the muscle preparation with fresh quantity of frog wringle for at least 4 times. Start the drum after stabilization. Take baseline for about 30 seconds on smoked paper. Now stop the drum and inject 0.1 ml of acetylcholine solution in the reservoir containing mounted muscle preparation. Start the drum immediately. Record the contractions for 90 seconds. You can see upward movement of writing tip of frontal writing lever on smoked paper. Stop the drum. Now relax the contracted muscle by rapidly washing with fresh quantity of frog wringle. Because of this, writing tip of lever slowly reaches towards baseline. Repeat the procedure by using 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4 ml of acetylcholine solution. For recording of each response to increasing doses of acetylcholine, 30 second baseline, 90 second response time and total 5 minutes time cycle is to be followed. Now measure the height of each response in millimeter. Height of response is indicative of muscle contraction. You can see that with the increasing doses of acetylcholine, muscle contraction increases. Hence, we can say that cholinergics increase spasmodic action.
Okay, so from this procedure we can easily observe that cholinergic category is a drug ahead which causes the spasmodic action, means they causes the contraction of that muscles, okay, involuntary contraction of that skeletal muscles. Here it is the observation table for different doses of acetylcholine. Okay, so here it is, we will see if dose will get increases, what is the effect of the height of contraction of that response of that particular muscle, skeletal muscle, that is rectus abdominis muscle. So this is the 0.1 ml of dose. Here it is the graph, you have to see the response height of this contraction is 13 mm. Okay, so this is the height of 0.1 ml. Then inject 0.2 ml of drug. You have observed from the graph is that the height of this response will get increases as the dose will get increases. Okay, so it is an 60 mm. Then 0.3. Furthermore, increase into the height of response, it is an 19 mm. At 0.4 ml of dose of acetylcholine, the height of response will get furthermore increase, it is an 20 mm of H, 20 mm of length. Okay. So, what indicate according from these different readings of responses, that is, as we increase the dose of acetylcholine, increase into the height of contraction. Okay. So, that indicates the tissue's contraction rate increases with the increase into the height dose of acetylcholine. So, what we can conclude it from that?
You have learnt that acetylcholine shows nicotinic actions at neuromuscular junctions of skeletal muscle. The contraction of muscle is achieved by triggering muscle action potential. Acetylcholine also increases spasmodic action of rectus abdominis.
Okay, so therefore from the observation we can easily conclude that acetylcholine causes contraction of rectus abdominis muscles of frog. Okay, so this is the effect of acetylcholine on the rectus abdominis muscles. It causes the contraction of that rectus abdominis muscle. So here it is the finish of experiment. Thank you.